I don't know of any other exercise in praise that would be more fitting just before our next minister of music, Keith Green. He's a beautiful brother in the Lord, one of the most exciting songwriters, one of the most exciting witnesses and evangelists. Keith is a great teacher. He's one of the most beautiful Christians I've ever met and one of the most talented musicians I've ever met. And I'm just so proud that he lives close enough that I can have almost daily fellowship with him. And I just wish all of you could. So welcome him so you can have tonight with him as Keith leads us. Keith Green.
These lyrics, you know, and I can't hear them when you're clapping. I was kind of partial, you know.
You know it ain't no use in banging your head up against that cold stone wall, 'cause nobody's perfect except for the Lord, and even the best bound to fall. Remember, he is divine and you a deep branch. He loved to get you through it if you gave him a chance. Just keep doing your best and pray that it's blessed, and he'll take care of the rest. Yes, the Lord said that he'd take care of the rest. He's gonna do it, but he'll take care of the rest. He'll see you through it, yeah, but he'll take care of the rest. The devil blew it, but he'll take care of the rest. Just think about Moses in front of the burning bush, barefoot on the holy ground. You know, he must have been thinking, hey, what's an old dude like me gonna tell them all when I go down, Moses. But the Lord said, hey, Mo, don't you worry about you going down south. I'll be saying every word that comes out of your mouth. You just keep doing your best and pray that it's blessed. Hey, Mo, I'll take care of the rest. Yes, the Lord said that he'd take care of the rest. He's gonna do it, but he'll take care of the rest. He'll see you through. He'll take care of the rest.
Old Pharaoh blew it.
He'll take care of the rest. Just believe and you'll receive that comfort you need. You just think about all those lonely people, you know. They got everything they want, but they got everything. Umbrella when there wasn't a cloud in the sky. All his neighbors would laugh at his pet giraffe, and they would snicker as he passed by. But the Lord said, hey Noah, be cool. You just keep building that boat. It's just a matter of time till they see who's gonna float. You just keep doing your best and pray that it's blessed. Hey Noah, I'll take care of the rest. I'm the weatherman. The Lord said that he'd take care of the rest. He's gonna do it, but he'll take care of the rest. He'll see through it, but he'll take care of the rest. His neighbors blew it. He'll take care of, he'll take care of, he'll take care of the rest. Okay, come on. He'll take care of the rest. Sing it with me, come on. He'll take care of the rest. Louder! He'll take care of the rest. Keep it going, come on, come on.
This next song is, it's definitely a song. It's interesting. Do you know, a lot of Christians feel like if they give their once a week to the Lord, they're doing real well, especially if they go every week. It's kind of like visiting a friend in jail, you know, like once a week. On Sundays, you know, visiting hours. Hi, Lord. How are you doing, Lord? Are they treating you okay in here? Is the food all right, Lord? We're working on getting you out soon. You know, and then I'll never forget the first... I'll never forget the first time I wrote out my first tithe check. It was kind of like... And Satan came and told me, you still got 90% left. I went, yeah, 90% for me. Lord goes, for who? Oh, hi, Lord. Well, that's kind of a joint account. Tell you what, I won't make any heavenly decisions. You don't spend any of my money. But you see, I was sitting around one day. I had this melody, and I just taught a Bible study on, remember Saul, king in the Old Testament? God told him to do something, and he did half of it. Patted himself on the back and gave the other half to the Lord as a sacrifice. The Lord said, I don't want your sacrifice, I want your obedience. I don't need your money, I want your life. And I hear you say that I'm coming back soon, but you act like I'll never return. Well, you speak of grace and my love so sweet, how you thrive on milk but reject my meat. And I can't help weeping at how it will be if you keep on ignoring my word. To prosper and succeed, but your flesh is something I just can't feed. I want more than Sundays and Wednesday nights. 'Cause if you can't come to me every day, then don't bother coming at all. Fire, not your prayers of ice. And I'm coming quickly to give back to you according.
you have done. According to what you have done.
You know, there's a little word in the Bible.
It's just one of them little ones. Just got two letters in it.
I think I've discovered it as one of the most neglected, well, it's one of the most important neglected words today. There's a lot of words that are more important that we're not neglecting. But this word is real important, but we're neglecting it quite a bit. It's just a little word. It's the word, I'm not going to tell you. It's the word do. Anyway, this is the... Can you imagine what the Bible would be like without the word do? Think of the, some of the scriptures. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and not what I say? And not what I say. Not everyone who saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom, but he who, the will of my Father. That's not do, that's does. It's a variation of the root word. Think about it. Not everyone who saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter the kingdom, but he who does the will of my Father. I've been doing this study of this little word do. Today, you know, for centuries, the church, the Roman church, way over there in Rome, was emphasizing works, 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 you know. And people would go, you're not working for the Lord, you're going to go to hell, you know. And so everybody took it all the way over here, to this extreme. And then Martin Luther came along, and he said, no, you don't have to do nothing to get into heaven, it's all grace. You're about, back over here. A couple people sit over here and, you know, right over here. Now, Martin Luther found a spiritual truth. It is not by works that you're saved, but by grace, lest any man should boast. And that's outrageously right on. Then, everybody sat over there and they started going, oh, wow, you don't have to do nothing to get into heaven. Glory to God. Praise, you know. It was almost like the full of business gospel man, you know. Uh-oh. It's okay, Billy Ray. So... anyway, everybody was over here on the right wing or the left. I don't care. There's no political whatever there. And everybody was going, we can just sit back and bask in the warmth of the Lord and just, you know, just bless me, come on and bless me, you know, woo, you know. And kind of looked like these 300-pound babies with these giant milk bottles. Getting fatter and fatter for Christ, you know, like the balloons in the Macy's Day Parade. Then there's all these scriptures about bearing fruit. Yes, but you see, you should get back to the Greek and understand that this really doesn't mean what it says. I mean, I had a friend that just got out of seminary. And he, you know, he's telling me, you know, that's the big cop-out now, you know. But you ought to see it in the Greek. Wow, you know. So I was reading this scripture about the fig tree, you know. Jesus went up to this fig tree, and the fig tree, and he says, can I have some figs? And the fig tree went, fig trees do that sometimes. He went, come on, a fig Newton, anything, I'm hungry. Yeah.
How about some bark? How about a leaf sandwich?
The fig tree just kept going. So Jesus cursed the fig tree, and it's the only thing that it's ever written that he cursed. I mean, I'm sure he had fun with the Pharisees too, but he cursed the fig tree, and the fig tree went, you know. Ever seen a fig tree do that? I haven't. So all the disciples went, wow, we ought to get in the tree removal business. I meant the disciples, I'm sorry. Didn't I say the disciples? Must have been something I ate. I love the Y food from afar. It's great. Praise the Lord. Well, I'm sure winning points, aren't I? So anyway, there was this parable about Jesus going up to this gardener, or about the Lord going up to the gardener and say, hey, what is this tree doing in my garden? It's got no fruit on it. Gardener said, well, boss, listen, we'll just dig around it and we'll graft on it and we'll fertilize it and we'll prune it. And in another year, if it doesn't have any figs on it, you can have fig firewood. Lord's like, I got enough firewood. Make me some figs. Plenty of firewood, you know. So the word do is really heavy. Now, I don't believe you got to do anything to get to heaven. You see, I don't think that an apple tree becomes an apple tree by making apples. An apple tree becomes an apple tree because the apple tree went, and apples came out. And then God put, you know, went, and there were apple seeds there. And the farmer put it in the ground, and an apple tree came up. And God went, and there was a farmer, too. But the apple tree grew out of nothing. I mean, out of the seed that God made out of nothing. Out of, from the apple that, you know, all the way back. Which came first, the apple or burpee seeds, you know? So I don't believe that an apple tree's got to do anything to become an apple tree. It's given that is from God, but it better make apples if it wants to stay in the orchard. According to the Bible, it's got to make apples or figs or whatever, you know, the fig tree making figs, or else it's not going to stay in the fig orchard. Aren't there orchards of figs? Anyway, the greatest scripture on the word do is in Matthew 25, verse 31 to the end of the chapter. It's very heavy stuff. Matthew 25, I'm sure a lot of people wish it wasn't there. But, you know, a lot of times we'll see starving children in pictures, you know, World Vision pictures or Christian mission pictures or whatever. And it's kind of like you've seen one starving kid, you've seen them all, right? They're, you know, you got to put them on your refrigerator. You know, you'll lose weight that way. And you have these pictures of starving kids, and you see lots of them and lots of them and lots of them, and you get numb to the thing. Well, it's another starving kid, Martha. You know, send them a nickel or something, you know? But if that starving kid was living on your block and he was, like, you know, rolling down the street with his bloated belly and his sunken cheeks and his hair falling out, you'd go get him some hamburger helper, anything, you know, quick. But if he doesn't live in your geographical location, then you don't have that much of a burden for him, because the poor you'll always have with you, right? The Son of Man comes in all his glory, and all the holy angels with him. Then shall he sit on his glorious throne, and he shall divide the nations before him, as the shepherd separates the sheep from the goats. And he shall put the sheep on his right, and the goats on his left. And he shall say to those on his right, the sheep, come ye, blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom before you. prepared for you before the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was naked, and you clothed me. Oh, I was sick, and you visited me. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. Oh, I was in prison, and I waited for you, and you came to me. Thank you. And we gave you something to eat? Or when were you thirsty and we gave you something to drink? Lord, I can't remember that. When were you naked and we clothed you? Lord, when were you a stranger and we invited you in? I mean, Lord, we invited lots of people in, but we can't remember seeing you there. Well, when were you sick or in prison and we visited you? I mean, we went to lots of prisons, Lord. We never saw you there. I mean, we knew you were there, but we never saw you. Lord, when? And as much as you've done it to the least of my brethren, you've done it unto me. Oh, yes. Inasmuch as you've done it to the very least of my brethren, you've done it unto me. Enter into your rest. Shall turn to those on his left, the goats. Depart from me, you cursed ones, into everlasting fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me nothing to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me nothing to drink. I was naked, and you never clothed me. I was a stranger, and I knocked, and I knocked, but you told me to go away. I was sick, and I was lying there in pain, and I waited for you, but you never came. I was in prison, and I rotted there, waiting for you. But I guess you had more important things to do. Depart from me, you cursed ones. Lord, there must be some mistake. Lord, when? Lord, when were you hungry or thirsty, Lord, and we didn't give you something? I mean, Lord, would you like something now? Wouldn't you angels go out and get the Lord a hamburger and a Coke or something? You're not hungry, Lord. Oh, well, Lord, when were you naked and we didn't clothe you? I mean, we didn't even have your chest size, Lord. That's not fair. But, Lord, this is something I got to know. When were you a stranger, Lord, and we didn't invite you in? I mean, we looked out the window every time, Lord. There were a lot of weirdos and creeps out there. I mean, Lord, that just wasn't our ministry. You know what I mean? You didn't want us to cast our pearls before swine, did you? Oh, now, come on, Lord. When were you sick? I mean, how could the Lord get sick? What did you have, anyway? Or in prison? I mean, you were in prison? What were you in for? As you have not done it to the least of my brethren, you have not done it unto me. That's all there is to it. Inasmuch as you've not done it to the very least of my brethren, you've not done it unto me. And these shall go away into everlasting fire, but the righteous into everlasting life. My friend, the only difference between these two groups of people, according to these scriptures, is what they did and didn't do. Sinking down. Don't you care? Don't you care? Are you gonna let them drown? How can you be so numb not to care if they come? You close your eyes and pretend the job's done. Bless me, Lord, you know it's all I ever hear. No one aches, no one hurts, no one even sheds one tear. But he cries, he weeps, he bleeds, and he cares for your needs. And you just lay back and keep soaking it in. Oh, can't you see it's such sin? He brings people to your door and you turn them away as you smile and say, God bless you, be at peace, and all heaven just weeps. 'Cause Jesus came to your door, you've left him out on the streets. Open up and give yourself away. You see the need, you hear the cries, so how can you delay? God's calling and you're the one, but like Jonah, you run. He's told you to speak, but you keep holding it in. Oh, can't you see it? The dark that the church just can't fight, 'cause it's asleep in the light. How can you be so dead when you've been so well fed? Jesus rose from the grave, and you can't even get out of bed. Oh, Jesus rose from the dead. Job's done.
job's done. Don't close your eyes, don't pretend the job's done. Come away, come away, come away with me, my love. Come away from this mess. Come away with me, my love. Do you see, do you see all the people sinking down? Don't you care, don't you care? Are you gonna let them drown?
Choir before. With a song that the Lord gave my wife. It's really neat to sing your wife's song. Make my life a prayer to you. I wanna do what you want me to. No empty words and no white lies. No token prayers, no compromise. I wanna shine the light you gave through your Son you sent to save us from ourselves and our despair. It comforts me to know you're really there. I wanna thank you now for being patient with me. Oh, it's so hard to see when my eyes are on me. I guess I'll have to trust and just believe what you say. Oh, you're coming again, coming to take me away. I wanna die and let you give your life to me so I might live and share the hope you gave to me, the love that set me free. I wanna tell the world out there you're not some fable or fairy tale that I've made up inside my head. You're God, the Son, you've risen from the dead. With me, oh, it's so hard to see when my eyes are on me. I guess I have to trust and just believe what you say. Oh, you're coming again, coming to take me away. Gave to me, I want to share the love that set me free.
Billy Ray asked me to close. Go ahead and be seated. I'm just going to preach for a few hours. I promise you're going to see the witness. Just in closing, make it easier for Jesus to come back this next year by living the life he asked you to live, so that others don't have to make excuses for the reason for what make excuses why Christians don't live the way Jesus asked them to. Let's just bow our heads and ask the Lord to pour out his Spirit on us as we leave. Lord Jesus, we come before you nothing but vessels made out of dust, Lord, that's held together by your Holy Spirit. We realize that we move and have our being in you. There's nothing we can do on our own. We're helpless creatures without you. And in you, Lord, we're more than conquerors. Lord Jesus, help us conquer the hypocrisy around us. And help us conquer the hypocrisy right inside of us through your Spirit and through the blood you shed. And as we go, Jesus, let us realize that the word Christian means little Christ, and we're supposed to be little Jesuses walking around by your grace. And in Jesus' name, we ask that you let that be in our lives in the next few days, the next few years, so that when you come back, we won't be ashamed at your appearing. In Jesus' name, amen. Go in peace.